just got up like a man possessed. He was...
There are a lot of things that upset people in sports these days. But one thing that will always remind fans is that there's still some good in the world. And those are acts of good sportsmanship. While some players enjoy gloating, talking trash, dabbing, and trying to humiliate their opponents, here are the 10 beautiful moments of respect in sports that will restore your faith in the athletic human race. And they all deserve to be appreciated. By the way, make sure to click that subscribe button to stay up to date with all our engaging videos, and use that trigger finger by smashing that like button. Without further ado, let's get on with it. Number 10. Kobe Bryant signs shoes or jerseys for opposing players. Los Angeles Lakers star, the late Kobe Bryant, made a reputation for being merciless on the court, not only going at opponents, but also laying some action into his teammates when he thought it necessary. But Bryant showed signs of humility and gratitude during his final NBA season by flashing a smile that many of us fans rarely saw, and doing unbeknownst things to show his appreciation to the sport. One of those things was his penchant for signing shoes for opponents, fans, and anyone else who wanted something to remember the Black Mamba by. Some may not find it a huge deal, but coming from a legend like Bryant, it was out of the ordinary and awesome to see. Number 9. Athletes who swap jerseys after games. I know that this happens after nearly every single soccer match, but for whatever reason, seeing players swap jerseys in the NFL is one of the cooler things I've seen in sports. A sign of respect and appreciation for an opponent, guys like wide receivers Calvin Johnson and Antonio Brown have done it, with plenty of others following suit after a game full of big hits. While little leaguers resort to high fives and handshakes following a match, some NFL players continue to take things to the next level by recognizing the abilities of other guys on opposite sidelines. Number 8. High school wrestler forfeits match for senior opponent to earn a career milestone. An entire Pennsylvania high school wrestling team deserves to be applauded for this move. Long story short, an opponent by the name of Lucas Ortiz was sidelined with a knee injury during his senior season and stuck on 99 career wins at Conestoga Valley High School, leaving him one short of that milestone of 100 victories. With members of the Chambersburg High team knowing Ortiz and hearing he was a good guy, the school's wrestler, Matt Strunk, decided to forfeit a match with him to give Ortiz that 100th high school victory. Strunk said, "Some of our guys know Lucas pretty well and said he's a really good guy, so we wanted to do something for him. I told the guys that Colin Runshaw should go up to 160, and I'll give up the forfeit at 152. It wasn't a hard decision for me. He's a senior and was stuck on 99 wins, and it was the right thing to do." Ortiz was appreciative of the gesture, adding, "That means a lot to me. Not so much because it puts me at 100 wins, but it just shows that they are great guys." Number 7. Derek Jeter bids farewell to Boston Red Sox fans. Every sports fan old enough to speak is familiar with the bitter rivalry between the Boston Red Sox and New York Yankees, as it stretches back all the way to the early 1900s. That's why the gesture former Yankees shortstop Derek Jeter did in his final MLB game in 2014 was so remarkable and classy. After hitting a game-winning walk-off single in the bottom of the ninth inning during his last at-bat in Yankee Stadium, which would have been an all-too-fitting end to his Hall of Fame career, the captain decided to honor the opposing fans, believing that he owed it to the Boston faithful to make an appearance rather than rest the final road stand. Jeter not only stepped onto the plate for one last time, he heard a raucous applause from Sox fans, but then thanked Red Sox greats to say goodbye. Number 6. Despite losing by 23 points, Desert Chapel High School gives a player with autism his shining moment. It's not very often that a team who's getting blown out is willing to let another team score. Yet, that's what happened during a basketball game in 2014 between two California high schools. Here's a breakdown of what happened. With Trinity leading 75-52 with less than a minute left to play, the team subs in 5'6" freshman Bo Howell, a player with autism, who, according to one of the announcers in the video, has become a source of inspiration for the team and its fans. His Trinity teammates immediately get the ball to Howell after the inbounds pass for an open look. The opposing Desert Chapel Eagles realize it and appear to be almost cheering on Howell themselves. Unfortunately, Howell misses both attempts, but there's still 40 seconds left on the clock, And Desert Chapel realizes that, too. So the Eagles call a timeout to set up one of the classiest moves you'll ever see. That's when things get a little emotional, as Desert Chapel inbounded the ball and literally handed it to Howell, with the inspiring kid sinking a bucket with about 20 seconds left on the clock. Number 5. High school runner carries opponent across the finish line. Over the years, we've seen a few instances of athletes lending a hand or shoulder to an injured opponent, and the one that occurred during a North Dakota cross-country race in 2014 got a lot of attention. After Fargo South High runner Danielle Lanoux felt a pop in her knee steps from the finish line that sent her to the ground, Devil's Lake High runner Melanie Bailey stopped, scooped up Lanoux, and helped carry her to complete the race. It was the final race of the season, so it made it even more memorable. Number 4. Red Sox pitcher sends bottle of liquor to batter he beaned. This is one of the most unique things I've ever heard a pitcher doing for a batter he plunked during a baseball game. With the Toronto Blue Jays' Chris Colabello at the plate, Boston Red Sox hurler Stephen Wright lost control of a pitch and beaned Cabello in the helmet, which is always a cause for concern. While the Toronto player ended up being okay, Wright couldn't help but check on him between innings and, after the game, even sent Colabello a bottle of liquor to apologize for the incident. Stephen decided that he was going to send over a gift, Colabello said, moving his clothes and uniform out of the way to show a large bottle of liquor sitting underneath. He didn't have to, he said Monday as he was getting ready for the annual Patriots Day game. I'm sure that's not cheap, too. Colabello said the act of a pitcher sending a gift to a player after hitting him happens more than people know. You build relationships with people. 3. Softball players carry injured opponent around bases. Assuming you have a soul, this one brings all the feels. In a 2014 college softball game between Eckerd College and Florida Southern College, Eckerd's Kara Oberer hit a 3-run home run off of Florida Southern senior pitcher Chelsea Oglevy, which would turn out to be her last pitch of her college career. As Oberer rounded the bases, though, her knee buckled and she was in agony. That's when Oglevy and a teammate stepped in, literally carrying Kara Oberer from second base to home plate to complete the round tripper. Number 2. The Turkish soccer team that leveled the playing field by allowing the opponents to score. During a Turkish league game last year, Kasımpaşa midfielder Ryan Donk scored a goal to put his team ahead during its match with Konyaspor. Problem was, it came while a Konyaspor player was injured and lying on the turf. Whether feeling guilty or because he's just a nice guy, Kasımpaşa manager Şota Arveladze actually instructed his team to allow their opponent to score an equalizing goal. Sure, allowing the other team to tie the match ended up biting Arveladze in the butt. The team lost 2-1 and he resigned shortly after the instruction, but the gesture was one that nearly 99% of coaches would have never even thought about doing. Number 1. Opposing teams giving retirement gifts to superstars. In normal life, sending a retirement gift to someone is the proper way to congratulate them on a job well done over their career, wishing them nothing but the best in whatever lies ahead. And in sports, opposing teams have gotten in on the act too, presenting gifts to players who have announced their intentions to call it quits ahead of their final season, allowing fans and other teams to pay tribute to him or her. As you might already know, the gifts are, well, interesting. There have been some that are real head-scratchers, but others that are thoughtful and clever, like the Minnesota Twins giving former New York Yankees closer Mariano Rivera a rocking chair made of shattered bats to signify how many pieces of wood Mo sawed off. Always amusing and a sign of respect, when a team gives another player a gift, it's fun for everyone. Which moment of respect in sports is your favorite? Let us know in the comments below, and we'll see you in the next video.